So we have received the different types of the minerals from the nature. Okay, and also we have environment, plants, forest. I mean, both are same, right? So such things which we have received by the nature, we have different, we have received this, different types of the minerals like coal, iron, gold, copper. So likewise, different types of the natural resources which we have received from the, you know, nature. And these all the natural resources we are using in our daily life. All the natural resources we are using in our daily life. So like what? Iron we are using for our electronic gadgets, as well as we are using for the furniture purpose, right? And if you take water, water also which is given by the nature, water we are using in our daily life. And if you take plants or the forest, which we are using for our, you know, shelter purpose. So likewise, whatever the natural resources are there, so these all the natural resources we are using in daily life. And we are using for infrastructure, we are using for the drinking purpose, we are using for housing purpose. Right, so these all, you know, daily life. In our daily life,
I'm mute all.
Right, so whatever the natural resources we have, either you see the natural resources which we have, like water, air, you know, forest, or earth. Are the complete environment which we have. This all we are using in our daily life for some other purposes. So all these natural resources are distributed equally. Distribution of natural resources. Or these natural resources are distributed equally on the earth? No. All the natural resources are not distributed equally on the earth. They are not, they in the sense, the natural resources are not distributed equally on the earth. Okay? Somewhere the natural resources are high, in some places the natural resources are medium, and in some areas the natural resources are less. Okay, in some places natural resources are high, and in some places natural resources are medium, and in some places natural resources are very low or very low. Likewise, on the earth, all the natural resources are not distributed equally. So, and even all the countries which are there on the earth, all the countries are not, you know, located with the natural resources on the earth. And for example, if you take the US has the world's largest coal reserves with 491 billion short tons, accounting for 27% of the world total. If you take US, United States, it is the largest producer of the coal. United States of America is the largest producer of the coal. In a year, it is producing 491 billions of billion tons of the coal it is producing. That means 27% of the coal in the world market is distributed by the United States of America. So of course the other countries also, they are providing the, see, they are also located with the natural resources, but compared to other countries, United States is producing more natural, I mean the natural resource like coal, it is producing more into the world market. So likewise, you can understand that all the natural resources are not located equally on the earth. In the same way, the Australia is also one of the country which is producing the second highest. Australia is also one of the country which is producing the second highest coal into the world market, into the global market. And if you take China, remains the largest producer of the gold with a 14% share of the global production. So, and if you take gold is also a natural resource. So China, we know China is very, China is well known for its technology. So not only technology, China is producing gold. Highest amount of the gold which is producing by the China into the global market. Global market in the sense the international market. Okay, China is the country which is producing highest amount of the gold into the global market. And it is producing 14% of the gold into the global market. China is producing 14% of the gold into the global market. And next, if you see, the United States, Russia, and Canada are the leading producers of timber and pulp. United States of America, Russia, and Canada. These are the countries which are producing the highest amount of the timber. You know timber, the wood, timber and pulp. Pulp which we use for the making of the paper, and timber which will be used for the furniture. And pulp which we use for the making of paper. Right? So in such a way, the countries are producing the natural resources, and annual export of primary and secondary wood products from tropical forests have exceeded $20 billion in recent years, and further increases are anticipated. And many countries have developed their economies by using their natural resources. Obviously, if your country is a very good in the natural resources, if a country is good in natural resources, okay, so automatically the country will be developed. Then we have the natural resources in our country also. We have all different types of the natural resources. Then what is the problem that our country still, it's after 74 years of the independence, why still India is a developing country? Because to use all these natural resources, we must require the technology. Okay, technology as well, we must need the, you know, people also, workers. This is the secondary thing, but technology is very, very important to extract the natural resources. So wherever the natural resources are more, in that country will be the developed country, because they use the natural resources, they sell it in the world market, and they will get the foreign income. See, foreign currency is, the other currencies in the world, they are more valuable. And especially if you take example of India, India currency is less than the other country. So if you take India, the resources which we have, so why we are not unable to, you know, make the developed country in India? Means the problem is that we don't have the proper technology here to use all the natural resources. Of course we have technology, but still we require more technology to use the natural resources, and our country can develop. And one more thing, if the natural resources are more, our country income also will be increased more. So like there are so many issues are based on the, you know, natural resources. If a country is located with the different types of the natural resources, so that country automatically it will be developed in the financial sector. And okay, so now these all natural resources we are using, all minerals we are using, all gases, you know, the gases which we are using, the natural gas also which is producing from the ocean bottom, and that is also a natural resource. And moreover, most important natural resource which we are using are oils. Nowadays oils are playing an important role in the human life. Oils in the sense, it may be petrol, diesel, or any other kind of kerosene, or any other kind of oils. So such kind of oils are playing an important role. So are we using these all oils in a proper way, or are we misusing it? Yes, of course we are misusing the natural resources. It may be minerals, it may be gases, or it may be the oils which we are misusing the natural resources. Then, and one more thing here, we are misusing, as well as the population is also increasing day by day. 120 crores of population above 120 crores above population we have in our country. And whatever the natural resources we have, those natural resources are not sufficient if we are using it continuously. Whatever the natural resources we have, okay, those natural resources are not sufficient for the people who are living in our country. So what we have to do? The first thing is that we have to, you know, use in a limited manner. In a limited manner, whatever the natural resources we have to use all the natural resources in a limited manner. For example, I will just tell you, when we are brushing or when we are, you know, taking bath, mostly for a human being, for bathing, or if you take a brushing, you require 1 to 2 liters of water is enough. Not even 2 liters, 1 liter of water is enough for brushing. But you know what we do? We use 3 liters, 4 liters of water for brushing. That means we are wasting the natural resources, isn't it? So if you observe the people, just I'm just explaining some examples to you, like how we are wasting the natural resources, right? And if you take another example, that if you observe the people near the traffic signals, okay, if you observe the people near the traffic signals, the, you know, the vehicles will be on. If you calculate throughout the country, if out of 120 crores of people, at least you take 50 crores of people are using the vehicles, and these vehicles are, you know, on near the signals, near the traffic signals, how much of the petrol, or how much of the diesel is going to waste, because the traffic signal may for 1 minute or some seconds, whatever it may be. If a vehicle is wasting 2 drops of water from one vehicle, just you calculate 50 crores of the people, 52 means more than 100, you know, liters of the petrol or diesel it is going to waste. So means we are misusing the natural resources. So to utilize the natural resources in a proper way, we have to conserve. We have to conserve the natural resources. What is mean by conserve? Conserve in the sense nothing but save or protect. Save or protect the natural resources. So how can we protect or how can we save the natural resources? Just now I have told you that these natural resources should sustain to the next generation also. So for that purpose, we can use a better policy, triple R system. Okay, we can follow the triple R system. What is meant by triple R? Reuse, reduce, and recycle. So whatever the, you know, products already you have used, again you reuse it so that there will be no harmful to the environment. Like for example, if you take plastic, right? So whatever the plastic products we have used, so such plastic products can be used again so that there will be no harm to the environment. Again, there is no need of wasting the natural resources. And the second thing is that reduce. Reduce in the sense, use less amount. Instead of using 10%, use 5%. So likewise, you can use the, you can reduce the use of your things. And the next one, recycle. So whatever the things are there that can be recycled and can be prepared the new things or new products or new kind of accessories you want, so that can be recycled and that can be used. So likewise, reuse, recycle, and reduce. So such a policy improves the natural resources and there will be no wastage of the natural resources with this policy triple R system. Then only, is this enough? Is the natural, you know, triple R system is enough to save the natural resources? No. And what should be done is the government should provide the public awareness to the people. Now, how the government is providing public awareness to the people, this corona situation, like each and now even in the rural areas also, the people will be knowing what kind of precautions they have to take for this situation, for the present situation. So likewise, the government should provide, some kind of education to the people. What kind of education it should be provided? What are the problems? What are the problems are there if we waste the natural resources? And, you know, how can they save or how can they conserve the natural resources? So likewise, such a kind of education can be provided for the people. The public education can be provided by the government to the people. So this is one where after triple R system, where we can follow the another kind of system, that providing public education to the people by the government. This is also one policy where we can save our natural resources. And the next one is government can issue some policies. Government can issue some policies. Like, for example, children, if you take Telangana government is a, you know, one policy was introduced by the Telangana government, that is Harita Haram. Why this Harita Haram is given to, you know, why they are implementing this policy in the Telangana? Because to increase the natural environment, to increase the forest area in Telangana, at least it should be 30% forest area wherever we are living. We don't have 30% forest area in Telangana or in the other states of the country. So every year, as per the constitution, every government should try to increase the forest area in that particular state and in our country. So accordingly, our Telangana government also, every year it plants some hundreds of plants in throughout Telangana state. So means such a kind of policies can be implemented by the government to protect the or to conserve the natural resources, to conserve the environment. And also the government should be firm with the you know, guidelines. Means whomever they want to extract the natural resources from a place, so the government should issue, you know, the limitations to the private companies. Whenever the most of the natural resources extraction can be done by the private companies, so what we can do is the government can implement the limitation. Okay, the government can implement the limitation for the extraction of the natural resources so that we can conserve our natural resources. And not only that, okay, so we should save our environment without pollution also. Nowadays pollution is a major problem in the country, especially the metropolitan cities like Delhi, where the population is more, even Hyderabad also, Kolkata, Mumbai. In such areas, what is the problem is pollution. Pollution is becoming a hectic problem to the people. So such, it may be pollution, again, it's different pollution. It may be air pollution, water pollution, land pollution, or noise pollution. There are different types of the pollutions are there. So these pollution, again, it should be in our control. So we have to stop polluting the environment. It may be land pollution, it may be water pollution, or it may be air pollution, or any other kind of, it may be sound or any other kind of pollution. We have to protect our environment, right? So what we can do, for example, take land pollution, which is going to decrease the value of the land, means the minerals of the land. If we are polluting the land, so this is going to decrease the value of the land. So we can suggest to the people, okay, to dump the whatever the garbage they are dumping, okay, that can be dumped in a different boxes. Like all the paper garbage, they can dump in one box. All the metal garbages, they can dump in one box. And any other kind of garbage, they can dump in one box. And glass in one box, like a plastic in one box, and other food items in one box. So when we are mixing all together, okay, so this is going to spoil the environment. when we are dumping it in a different way. See, for example, metals which are there, if you are depositing all the metals in one box, so this can be recycled again. The paper can be recycled again, right? The glass can be recycled, plastic can recycle, right? Food items also, nowadays with the spoiled food, people are making the, you know, gases. The people are producing the gases which we can use in our domestic works, as well as electricity also they are making with a spoiled food. They are making the electricity also, even in our Warangal also they are making it electricity. They are preparing with the waste garbage, right? So likewise, if you are dumping the you know, the wastage in the different boxes, so which can be recycled, which can be dumped into the garbage area, dumping at. So likewise we can do, and we can save our environment. And also water conservation is also very, very important. Have to conserve the water. Already I have told you, water conservation is also very, very important. Nowadays we people are wasting a lot of water. See, in the summer season we will understand, maybe all the people, but some of the people, they will understand what are the problems for the water. What are the problems for the water? So what we have to do is, as we have taken from the past generation, we have to provide the water for the future generation too. Right? We have to provide the water for the future generation also. So what we have to do to conserve the water also, because water is also one of the natural resource. So nowadays water problem is becoming a big issue even in the cities as well as in the rural areas also. So we have to conserve the water also. Water is also one of the natural resource. So how can we conserve the water? How can we conserve the water? We have to use less water in our daily life. Okay, we have to use less water in our daily life. And second thing is that we have to turn off, the tap when it is not in use. When we are not using the tap, we have to turn off it. And don't allow the rainwater, draining into the drainages.